Hi guys and welcome back to our channel. Today we'll be analyzing three cryptocurrencies, which are Synthetix, Network Token, Waves and Kusama. We will see where the three cryptocurrencies might move over the next weeks and months, and I will be releasing some price target. Please subscribe to our channel if you want us to keep releasing technical analysis and price predictions for free. Also like our videos and leave a comment. You will also see a link on the description section where, if you want, you might join our growing Patreon community. Let's start with Synthetix Network Token. What we see here is a 2D chart, which means every candle is a 2-daily one. After having hit a double top at $7, I was expecting a strong retrace. So if you had a chance to see my previous YouTube videos, you know that I was expecting for a strong retrace. Actually, from $7, we have experienced a strong retrace till $2.5, which means almost 60% of retrace. Right now, what we see is quite important. We see an increase in terms of volumes with four long white candles. The most important one is the second one, which has broken above the oblique resistance, which can be obtained by linking all this point of high. So with the second long white candle, we actually right now know that we are again in an uptrend. Okay, so where we might see Synthetix Network Token over the next weeks and months? Definitely first target at $6. We're going to hit $60 in a very fast way. From there, I do believe we're going through a very fast period of squeezing to then attack $7. In terms of MACD, we see that the very first time we have a very first histogram above the zero, yet the two curves are still below the zero, which is a negative signal, with the blue curve crossing below the orange one. Now, in order to see Synthetix Network Token skyrocketing after hitting the all-time high at $7, in terms of MACD, we need the both the curves have to be above the zero line, which means the derivative is positive. Okay, now let's move on and let's see what we might see for Waves. So again, for Synthetix Network Token, $6 and $7 are my target for the next weeks and months. Let's see Waves. Waves have right now a relative strength higher than Synthetix Network Token, and as I've been stating several times, we're going to hit the all-time high around $4.7. Now, if we switch to the weekly chart, we will see better, we will have a better view, a better scenario for what we should be expecting over the next months. But in this case, just let me say that, as you can see here, both the curves are for the MACD above the zero, which is actually a much better signal if compared with what we have seen with Synthetix. As you can see here, Synthetix, both the two curves are still below the zero, while for Waves are above the zero, which is an extremely positive signal. Also, the two curves are positively oriented, which means the derivatives is above the zero, another very strong signal. Let's move on and let's switch to the weekly chart in order to better understand where I said the all-time high, sorry, but obviously the relative high at $5. Now, what we see here, actually the very first resistance in this case will be $6. Okay, so $6 will be a very strong threshold, a very strong horizontal resistance from where I do believe Waves will be retracing strongly. So again, we are now going to hit the relative high for the 2020, definitely, and after actually breaking above this area, I do believe we are going to very fast hit $6. From $6, I do believe we are going through a period of squeezing line in this case, so we should be expecting a retrace before attacking the new all-time high at 18, or the old all-time high at $18. So now let's be patient. Right now, the most important thing that we can see here, and that I've haven't said so far, is that what we see here is a huge increase in terms of volumes. As you can see here, we have a huge point of control. Now, if you compare this volume with the previous ones, you can easily understand how Waves seems to be in strong hands, which means, in other words, that some institutionals or someone that say more jerkily saying the strong hands are now buying waves in a very strong way. Now, if we observe the MACD on a weekly chart, we see actually a strong bullish divergence. While actually we've seen here two bottoms, okay, so two low with the waves moving almost horizontally. Here we see actually that MACD has higher lows, okay, with the very first time, for the very first time, we see that both the curves are above the zero. While in this case, as you can see here, both the curves were below the zero. And in this case, we have experienced a movement between $4 and 0.80 US dollar. Okay, so $6 is for me the next target for waves. Now let's move on. Let's analyze Kusama. Even in this case, we want to start from the MACD. We see that both the curves are above the zero, which is the very first important signal, with the very first histogram for the first time above the zero, and with the blue curve, which is positively oriented, while the orange one is horizontally oriented. Now let's move on and let's analyze the weekly chart in order to give you some price predictions, okay, for Kusama over the next weeks. What do we see here? Actually, we are in right now the quotation is 35 US dollar, 0.34, where we're going to see Kusama. Okay, we've broken above this oblique resistance, so very first target to me is 50 US dollar. Right now we are actually inside a very strong bullish uptrend. This retrace has to be considered just a retrace from a strong uptrend. So this retrace is not the beginning of a downtrend. And with the new long white candle breaking above this area, breaking above 37 US dollar, we are definitely going to hit 50 US dollar. So again, we need now a new long white candle breaking above this area, and then we are going to see Kusama hitting 50, if not 60 US dollar. So what I expect right now is an increase in terms of amplitude, which makes the difference between the high and the low. We might see some sort of long white candle like this one. Thank you, guys.